Now for our Bible reading.
Love, hard as nails, soft
Scotland. Now, when we listen to that story which Elizabeth has read for us, we hear the story of a lady who in that passage is unnamed. But we know her name from other parts in the Bible, and it's a bit of a strange name, so we've got to get our tongues around it. Her name, Mum's name, in that story is Jochebed. Can you say that with me?
Jochebed.
Marvellous. And we know as well from other bits of the Bible what the elder sister's name is. Anyone know what the elder sister's name is? Brian's got his hand up. I'm hoping someone else might know. Anyone going for it? Moses. Miriam, that's right. So we've got these two women in this story who are exhibiting really extraordinary, tough love. Jochebed has held Moses in her arms. She's nursed him, but she knows she can't hide him any longer from the Egyptians. And she knows that she keeps it. He will die. And so she and Miriam hatch this plan to create a basket. It's covered in pitch. And you can make a basket with your hands like this. And it is placed in the reeds. And I think Jochebed, her heart must be breaking in this moment. But Miriam stops on and watches to see what will happen. And marvelously, in this story, in the providence of God, Pharaoh's daughter comes along with all sin that they're having, and there they are at his net. She draws him from the water, and her servants go and suddenly Miriam pops up and says, well, you'll need a nurse for him. I know someone who could just do the job. And of course, he's Jochebed with a heart which is as strong as anything, hard as nails, and soft as bone. You know, when we've been watching the television series of what's going on in Ukraine, not going to dwell on it too much, but we need to know what's going on there. One of the things that has struck me more than anything else is those images of women, many of whom are mothers, waving goodbye to children as they are placed on trains, perhaps wondering when they will hear from them again. And the reason they are doing that is because their love for their children, like Jochebed, is as hard as nails and as soft as cotton. You know, mums are incredibly resilient and brave. They are full of courage. Just think about when you've got a spider in the room. What does your mum do for you? She gets rid of it. Yeah, there's a few shakes of it. Yeah. Hard as nails, soft as cotton. The two picture those mothers in Ukraine leading children around like those audience. Hard as nails, soft as cotton. Incredible, incredible love. And it's an image we see repeated time and time again in the Bible. We see Mary bring Jesus to the temple when he's just a few days old. And what are the words that are spoken over Jesus from Mary? That our heart will be pierced because of what's going to happen to Jesus. What about for him? Hard as nails, strong as God. And we see Jesus talking about Jerusalem. How I've longed, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, how I've longed to draw everyone there showing God's love for us, like a mother hen who gathers in her chicks sleepily under her wings. A mother's love, as Brian spoke for us just a few weeks ago. Hard as nails, soft as cotton. And in this story, we see ultimately a picture of mother's love, which is just a reflection of God's love for you and for me. Hard as nails, soft as cotton, the Lord is a strong tower for all who will run to him. Hard as nails. And yet, underneath are the everlasting arms in the Lord. This is the God who loves you. And we see it in every mother. You know, there's a saying, isn't there, that you never come between a mother, a bear, and a cubs. Yeah, because the thing will, that's not a safe thing to do. You don't do it. And we see that reflected in those moments that we see it reflected in the story of the book. We see it reflected in the story of Mary. And so today, we will thank God for mums everywhere. We will remember those mums in Ukraine, in our prayers. And we see in them, we see in our mums, the glimpse of our Heavenly Father's love for us, which all the way to the cross in Jesus, as hard as nails, the nails that pierced him, and as soft as the cotton that they wrapped him. Amen.
Thank you. loving God, our Heavenly Father, in our worship today we say thank you for all that our mothers are to us, and for all that they do for us, for their love is as hard as nails and as soft as butter. But we also know that for some people this is a difficult day when they hurt, grief, and perhaps anger. We pray that you will draw alongside those who are hurting today to comfort them and surround them with your tender care. God of compassion, fill us with your love. We pray for women who grieve because they are unable to have the children they so long to have in love. For mothers who grieve because, like Mary, they have had to see their child die too soon. For mothers who grieve because they are cut off from their children by disappointment, anger, or bitterness. For mothers like Jennifer who are worried or afraid for their child's well-being or safety. We ask you, Heavenly Father, to bring healing, comfort, forgiveness, and peace into the hearts and minds of hurting mothers. God of compassion, fill us with your love.
We pray for all the children who grieve because they have lost their mothers through illness, accident, or violence. The children whose mothers have been unable to give them the love and care they need, so that they now live in families and homes which are not their own. For all the children who are still living in homes that are unsafe, or adults who cannot put the children's needs before their own. The children who, through hardship and poverty, are not being provided with an adequate diet or basic medical care. We ask you, Heavenly Father, to bring love and security, courage and hope into the lives of hurting children today. God of compassion, we ask you, Heavenly Father, to bring healing and forgiveness into the lives of all those who today bring back painful memories of broken relationships and loss. Help us all to find in the brothers and sisters of Christ a loving family with whom we may show you love and tender care for all your hurting children. God of compassion,
yes,
loving God, trusting in your promise to hear us when we pray in faith, we ask you to bless our relationships in the families of our homes, our children, and our communities, so that through our lives your loving will for us may be done, and so we pray in Jesus' name.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
In a minute, Denise is going to lead us in a prayer, and we're going to give these flowers out, and it will be great if some of the medical organisations can help us with that as we try to get them out to everyone they need who's here. Now, we've got 150 of these, which is more than enough to go around. You'd love me to take one for your neighbours as well. What I don't want to do is, you know, knocking on Denise's door, you know, and seeing a wonderful spray of, you know, people all the way out the bathroom. But if you have got a neighbour who would just appreciate, I know we've got one that we're planning to knock on the door for today, just to give them something to encourage, something a bit sad, and say, actually, this comes from Holy Trinity with love, with thought in mind. That would be great. We'll get rid of them, don't worry, over the week. But if you've got a neighbour that you'd like to take on board, then if you could form an order of key young people, and Jenny and Chandler will help you out. Yeah. Okay. And the musicians will lead us up. But before we do that, we are going to sit down, Max. Sorry, Denise is going to lead us in these prayers. And we need to have our sheets sort of tucked in our hands, but then we need to quickly put them under our arms so that we can do the actions that go with them. You got that? So it's like that. See what you're doing, pop it under your arm, and then you'll be good. Is that okay?
Praise God.
sing it from the top.
Praise God who loves us.
Praise God who cares.
Thank you, God, that you love each one of us. Thank you, God, for the love of God, past, the present, and still to come. Thank you, God, for those, help those who don't feel safe today. Thank you, God, for all the people who work to take care of us every day. Keep us close to your love each day. Amen.
Now, Max, you can come and form that queue.
Thank you.
God who loves us.
Praise God who cares.
God of grace and compassion, your Son Jesus Christ was part of a family in Nazareth. He knew the love of the mother and of the father, and by dying on the cross, brought us all together as a new family. Help us on the Christian journey to strive for that day when the whole of humanity is one family together in your church. Amen.
And so may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, whose love for us is as strong as an eagle and soft as fire. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you all and all those